Mega Conquerors and Lynx.
Spots one outside of the smoke, and Peter gets himself a little cover. But oh,
oh
my goodness,
the spray!
Spray over to Hazel as well, and high. It will be a double knockdown coming in from the members of Illuminate the Murder. Arm just what on earth was that? But look at G9. G9 climbs up the hill, meets up with the rest of Mega Conquerors, and now Raphael's pretty low. He needs to heal up. Only 4 more packs going in, and this is our top 5 playing on top of the hill.
Oh my goodness, Mega Conqueror just finding everybody at the top of this hill. We talked about the smoke and how Snowlinks was a little bit unfortunate because Illuminated the Murder, the right timing as well to spot one member just outside. And look at this, Armjoy, he started off this battle and he wants to finish Hazel off.
And there we go, one more knock over on the side of Hazel. It's only I with one dot of health. And there goes the spray down and Armjoy finish up pretty quickly.
Yeah, we talked about the Snow Ghillie suit, and honestly, look at how aggressive he's playing. He doesn't really even need the Ghillie suit. He looks like a Yeti that's running straight at you.
That's right, and Spear Yetis, they don't exist no more. Here comes Goddard trying to break down that UAZ, looking for RRQ, he's gonna on top of the hill. And Gudart, this are a lot of all the high time playing this one out. It's between 3 tie teams that we're talking about here.
I mean, honestly, we spoke about how
Illuminated the Murder is gonna rotate about taking those smaller compounds, taking by
stone.
The edge of the circle. Oh my goodness, Armjoy 1-4! Oh my goodness, 6 times on that M4!
Yeah, I was just about to say Stone, he was playing a little bit too aggressively outside this move, not really paying respect to where Illuminated the Murder were, and he's gonna pay the price for that. Meanwhile, we see B2E once again popping off onto members of Online 24, and we're gonna see Armjoy get another snipe as well. The Yeti is here! Feel for your life, because the Booty Man is here to wipe out your teams, and RRQ will join the party as well, already getting a kill to pawns. Every single member of these 3 teams are falling like flies, and we are down to our final 8 still alive. Illuminated the Murder and RRQ, which of these side teams will get the winner with the chicken dinner?
He's just a monster, he's not just a Yeti, he's just taking every single one of these guys, and now Matoy's match is bought out senior. So all these positions for RRQ Tina has been revealed. Illuminated the Murder, as much as they are on the lower section of the map, they do have all the advantages that they can possibly get. Here comes Andrew with an AWM once more. He's already spending too much of that. Oh, that's a huge damage output coming from the life of senior. But of course, he's gonna go in for the reload, and he's just gonna pull a lot more taps over the members of RRQ. 4 by 4. So which side are you taking here, my friend?
I mean, I spoke about Mega Conqueror being the crazy one to drive in the middle. And speaking about crazy, Armjoy coming in. Baba Kanoosh gets the spray down as well. He manages to get one down. And now they know that there's only 3 members still up and standing. And look
here
at that. They are going for the hunt. They try to revive the teammate. But the Molly is going to put them out of position. He's going to abandon his teammate right there. And now it's down to a 3v3. We've got Guda taking so much fire from the members as well as D2E. He's got so many things to juggle on his mind. And he will get knocked down from the side. Matoy, the support of the team, managed to find the angle. And Stars and Senior is going to fall as well. It's out to a 1v1. Oh, G9. How is he going to play this?
Armjoy versus G9. Let's see which one of these Thai Titans will be able to walk away with the win. He goes in for a spray. Almost knocked out G9. But G9 goes in for the rescue. Is he going to go in for a revive as well? He's going to go in to pick up Martin. But in this tight situation, it's between either one of these 2v2 scenarios. But there is... Remember, he's going to go for a spray down here. And G9 only got that Ironside AK. He's trying his luck. They're also going for the revival as well. So this is a 3v3 scenario for the very final phase of this match.
Talk about G9, and Icy Baby was calling him the god, and now he's going for the spray down as well. They are on the hunt for this Yeti, but the Yeti will bite back. Now it's down to D2E, and now they managed to break down one more kill to Armjoy. The Yeti on the floor, but now they're still as well. Martin coming on the side, Martin. They know that RRQ are hiding behind the bridge, or rather the
stone.
And soon enough, it is Athena from RRQ. They managed to search out the winner.